A very good morning, friends. Today we will discuss about an important amino acid, that is methionine. Today we will discuss about the metabolism of methionine. This is an essential amino acid, and metabolism of amino acid cysteine and cysteine. It is considered together because methionine is ultimately converted into cysteine, and two molecules of cysteine will give cysteine. So we will discuss the methionine metabolism under three headings. The first one is the transmethylation reaction. And conversion of methionine into homocysteine. Second step in the methionine metabolism is the cysteine synthesis. And third is the degradation of cysteine. So we will discuss it step by step: transmethylation, conversion of methionine into homocysteine, formation of cysteine, and degradation of cysteine. So this is essential amino acid converted into cysteine. If we give the dietary cysteine, that will reduce the requirement of methionine, that is known as sparing action of cysteine on methionine. This methionine, it is utilized for the protein synthesis. Then it is a glucogenic amino acid. It will give glucose. Then glycine, arginine, methionine, it is utilized for the synthesis of creatine. And methionine is important in various transmethylation reaction and gives different biological products. Now coming to the methionine metabolism proper. In the methionine metabolism, this is methionine. It is converted into S-adenosylmethionine, that is SAM, which is a universal methyl donor. It is also known as activation of methionine into S-adenosylmethionine. The molecule of ATP is required here, and this ATP is converted into inorganic pyrophosphate and inorganic phosphate, and it gives S-adenosylmethionine. There is transfer of adenosyl group from ATP to the sulfur of methionine, and there is formation of S-adenosylmethionine. This is by the methionine adenosyl transferase. As three energy bonds are utilized here, it is equal to the utilization of three ATP molecules. That makes this reaction irreversible. Now this S-adenosylmethionine, it is converted into S-adenosylhomocysteine. And in this reaction, there is release of methyl group, which is taken by the acceptor. Take one example. It is taken by the acceptor. Suppose it is norepinephrine. It is converted into epinephrine. So it is taken by the acceptor and converted into the another product or important product. This is catalyzed by the enzyme methyl transferase. So it is important, it is known as transmethylation reaction. Now this S-adenosyl homocysteine, with the help of homocysteinase, there is liberation of adenosyl here, and it is converted into homocysteine. And this homocysteine is converted into methionine. So two reactions are important here. First is the methyl transferase reaction, and second one is the, it is given by methionine synthase. For this reaction, B12 is required. Vitamin B12 is required. And in this reaction, there is utilization of methyl tetrahydrofolate, which is converted into tetrahydrofolate. So these two reactions are important. This methionine synthase is vitamin B12 dependent. It requires methyl tetrahydrofolate. In this reaction, with the help of vitamin B12, it is converted into tetrahydrofolate and homocysteine is converted into methionine. But in vitamin B12 deficiency, this tetrahydrofolate get trapped as methyl tetrahydrofolate, and there is functional deficiency of tetrahydrofolate that is known as folate trap. Folate trap in the deficiency of vitamin B12. So this is the first step in the methionine metabolism, that is conversion of methionine into the homocysteine and transmethylation reaction. Now moving to the second. In the second step, this homocysteine is converted into a cysteine. Now homocysteine here condenses with the molecule of serine, and this gives cystathionine. With the help of PLP dependent enzyme, that is cystathionine beta synthase. This is PLP dependent enzyme, pyridoxal phosphate dependent enzyme, and it will give cystathionine. And this, with the help of cystathionase, which is again a PLP dependent enzyme, that is cystathionase or cystathioninase, it is also a PLP dependent enzyme. This cystathionine is converted into cysteine. So it is, there is formation of cysteine plus homoserine, and this homoserine undergoes the deamination and decarboxylation, and it gives propionyl coenzyme A. Propionyl coenzyme A, which is converted into succinyl coenzyme A, and it enters into the TCA cycle. So via this pathway, it will results in the formation of glucose. So this is how the methionine and cysteine, they are glucogenic. So this is the second step in which homocysteine condenses with the serine. Then there is formation of cystathionine, and cystathionine, with the help of cystathioninase, it is converted into cysteine and homoserine. This is again a PLP dependent enzyme, cystathioninase or cystathionase. Now the cysteine molecule which is synthesized here, it has sulfur from the homocysteine, means it has sulfur from the methionine, and rest of the molecule is from the serine. So this is the second step in the methionine metabolism, that is formation of cysteine. On condensation with the formation of disulfide linkage, it is converted into cysteine. Cysteine is a derivative of cysteine. On condensation of two molecules of cysteine, it gives cysteine. Now coming to the third step in the metabolism, that is degradation of cysteine. And it is somewhat complex as compared to this. This is the easy. Now coming to the discussion of degradation of cysteine. So it is somewhat complicated process, that is the degradation of cysteine. Remember the product given by the cysteine in the cysteine degradation. This cysteine, it is converted into mercaptoethanolamine, which with pantothenic acid gives coenzyme A. So this is the first product given by the cysteine. Now second, this cysteine by the cysteine sulfinase, it gives cystic acid and it gives sulfide. Cystic acid and sulfide. So this cystic acid, it is utilized for the production of taurine. So it is utilized in the synthesis of bile salt. So it is important, cystic acid, it gives the taurine. The bile salts are taurocholate, glycocholate, they are bile salts. So it helps in the synthesis of bile salts. Then this sulfite, it helps in the formation of phosphoadenosine phosphosulfate, which is utilized in the mucopolysaccharide synthesis, and it is also utilized in the detoxification process. Phosphoadenosine phosphosulfate. Then in the third reaction, it is converted into pyruvate, and pyruvate will give you glucose. So it is glucogenic amino acid. So this is the degradation of cysteine. It gives coenzyme A, taurine, sulfite, which leads to the formation of phosphoadenosine phosphosulfate, which is a universal sulfate donor. Then it is converted into pyruvate, which gives the glucose. There are three important disorders which are related to the methionine, cysteine and cysteine. The first important disease, it is first one is the cysteine urea. In this disease, there is defect in absorption of cysteine, arginine, lysine, cysteine, ornithine, lysine and arginine in the urine. Due to the defective reabsorption of this amino acid in the renal tubule, This is the first disorder. There is increased excretion of cysteine, ornithine, lysine and arginine in the urine, in cysteine urea. Second is the cystinosis. In cystinosis, there is accumulation of cysteine in the blood and accumulation of cysteine in the reticuloendothelial system, especially in the lysosome. It results in the damage to the spleen, liver, bone, etc. Cystinosis. There is increased level of cysteine in the blood. And third important disease is homocystinuria. So it is important, it is due to the deficiency of cystathione beta synthase. And due to that, there is increased level of homocysteine in urine and blood. As there is increase in the homocysteine level, it leads to the cardiovascular episode. It leads to the CVS diseases, cardiovascular diseases. Because this homocysteine interferes with the collagen cross-linking. Collagen formation, it interferes with the lysyl oxidase, interferes with the collagen formation, and it leads to the aggregation of LDL particles. And aggregation of LDL particle leads to the coronary artery diseases. So this is the This is due to the increase in the homocysteine level. It present as cardiac events. Also, there is mental retardation and there is subluxation of lens. Subluxation of lens. So, these are the clinical manifestations of homocysteine urea. Some book mentioned there are four types of homocysteine urea, 1, 2, 3, 4. This is in the defect 1, cystathione beta synthase. In 2, there is reductase deficiency. And 3 and 4, there is methyl transferase deficiency. So, these are the three disorders, cystinuria, cystinosis and homocysteine urea. These are the three disorders related to the methionine metabolism. This is all about the methionine, cystine and cystine. Keep watching. Thank you.